this is reality TV that works. Startups, made in Kansas City.
The whole idea for the Paw Wash started for my sixth grade science fair project. I was 12 years old and I had no idea what I wanted to do. So I always had the daily chore of cleaning my dog Sadie's dirty paws. And I thought there had to be an easier way to do this. So I thought I'd kill two birds with one stone and create something to clean her paws and get me an A in the science fair. So that's exactly what I did. I first created some different things with bowls and stuff, and then we went to the barn and got some PVC pipe, and I bought a cap for it, filled it up with water, put some soap in it. My dad actually used it on Sadie, and that's when he told me, hey, Katie, this works, you know. It was...
I was in the garage,
yeah,
and doing some work, and the dog ran in muddy. I put some water in the... Back then, we didn't name it the paw wash.
Yeah, it was this device. Tube.
Put some soap in it and water, and then put Sadie's paw in it and cleaned it, and muddy paw's gone, and it's a white lab's paw that came out, and that's when I went in the house and said, you have something here. You need to put some graphics on it and name it. And then she named it the Paw Wash.
I handle customer service, the logistics, the shipping, the bookkeeping, and the marketing for the Paw Wash. It is currently sold not only on our website, and you can click a link that says retail locations, and up pops a map of the United States, and it covers all the stores that we sell in. It truly all began with Three Dog Bakery throughout the Kansas City area selling the product, and they are a big local seller of it, especially their store down on the plaza. But it's also sold by distributors here in the United States, and those distributors sell to stores, and we sell it worldwide.
Well, it was not my first thought to get a patent when I first came up with the Paw Wash. As a 12-year-old kid, all I was interested in what color I wanted it, what designs and stickers I wanted to put on it. But when we actually got the Paw Wash going, my dad said, no, we need to get this patented. And I was like, oh, okay, cool. I really had no comprehension of what a patent was.
Just the applications and the cost of a patent can be $20,000, $25,000. And after that, then you have to have a factory to make your product. So you have to have molds made. Molds, $20,000. You've got a large and small unit. And you have mitts. So right there, you're probably at $50,000. And then your first run, you can do a short run, which it's more expensive per unit, just to test the waters like we did to see how it would sell. But then when you make a big run with a container, like a 40-foot container or a 20-foot container smaller, then you're getting into the $60,000, $70,000 orders, so on and so forth. And then as you go along too, you have to have attorneys involved, so there's cost incurred there. But I would say literally $250,000 just to get this company going.
A lot of people think I am really rich or a millionaire, but sadly, I'm not. Since I've been copied so many times, people say it's a great compliment, but it's extremely costly.
First of all, what happened is I got a phone call from a friend who said, hey, congratulations, I saw your product on TV. And I said, we're not out yet. We've got our prototypes and things like that. We have our patent, but we're not, you know, out of the market. He goes, well, there's something just like yours that you need to look into. So again, we looked into it and contacted our local council, got the product sent to us, investigated it, and they found that one of the claims they felt was being infringed on.
And maybe I would have been a lot further, my profit would have increased a lot if I hadn't had to go through all these lawsuits and troubles, but I mean, that is where the passion comes out of having the Paw Wash, as it's my baby, it's my passion, it's everything. And having my awesome team behind me keeps us pushing forward. You have to have a family member or a friend or somebody who's going to actually believe in the product to keep it going. Because if you're the only one with the passion and there's no one there to help you or support you, then it's going to be really hard, because you go through some really hard times, and having a good family to stay up late with you and box them or do whatever is the best gift. With all the money and the funds my parents put into it, there's no way this would have gotten to the point where it is today, because a 12-year-old doesn't have that type of money, doesn't even understand. I didn't even understand how much money that would have ever been. So without my parents, my idea would just be an idea and wouldn't be anywhere to where I am today.
As a former teacher, I really enjoyed teaching others, but I have been taught a lot as this business has grown. China, manufacturing, making sure that it arrives in this country, putting containers on the water to get here, and then over to the warehouse, and from there, the shipping and the logistics. It's been a learning experience for that aspect of all that is involved when a product comes to market from the ground up.
Why we chose to get the product made in China instead of the U.S. is basically because of the price point.
We would want to make it here in the United States, but mold cost here in the United States could be $100,000 for what we have versus $20,000. We looked at local companies here in Kansas City and around the country, great people. And they even said to us, we can't do it, and because you can't even get it on the market so that the consumer could buy it at a good price.
It's truly still a small organization in terms of when I said shipping and logistics. I box them, I ship them out, I go to UPS, and that's a lot how we do our shipping and the postal service. So it's still just truly a small organization, though sold worldwide. Of course, it will be the dream that there's enough financial backing in the future as the business grows, that you are able to have that warehouse that definitely packs it all for you and ships it for you and gets it out. But currently, it's just mom and pop and me doing it and taking the calls. And so it's fun. It's full-time fun.
While my profit isn't exactly where I'd like it to be, there's always going to be dirty paws, and my business is growing and expanding, and I believe in it with all my heart, and I have the best team behind me, and I know we are going to continue to grow and do even more wonderful things.
A co-production of KCPT and Outpost Worldwide, at home in Kansas City. Production, post, content.